Kubor Kabate City TV Lawanda Shapi Daka Orange Nissan Looms Hopo near Fire Brigade Shillong Ringkat Bakanet Foodish Order Mapi Ninwan Ramangi Hakker Dog Ying Jongpi
Katanat Penroy Sor Jong Kasor Karjela Kalatawlat Ban Yo Jingerap Ling Baki Scheme Bapair Ban Sdang No Yaka Jing Bun Ko Yakawa Umkra Bat Kawa Sirpi Kibalong Ki Artali Kiwa Kibalasha Penjabo Hadu Kata Kata Hapo Kanika Sor Shilo Menteri Katanat Forest and Environment U James P.K. Sangma Habaya Keren Bat Kabati CTV Uliyatho Bakatanat Penroy Sor Kan Sakot Tender No Marmar Na Kebenta Ban Penko Yaki Diki Artali Kiwa Kumbalabu Thong Ban Penko Idru Yakawa Luka Kabadan Ha East Gentia Hills District Kabalasha Penjabo Na Kajingti Doyong Ban Na Kajing Pento Jaklia Na Kikarkana Kibadan Hapo Kanika District Kat kum kajingi tho jong ujib sangma ka sorkar kala thubu ban bin kho yegini ki artli ki wa ki bajutu lingba ka donot jong ka sor shlong da ka basai ka pisar na ka migalia minor minerals reclamation fund but na ki wei ki wei ki scheme
right now what's happening is that the urban affairs department has I believe come up with certain schemes whereby they are seeking cleaning up of the Vamkra and the Umshirpi River, and so they will be doing they'll be floating, or they have already floated maybe expression of interest or tender in that regards. But yes, there's always ways by which we can supplement this effort, which will be complementary in nature to clean up our rivers. At the end of the day, whatever steps and measures we take will never be enough. So we must keep up the vigil. We must always ensure that we do maximum to reclaim whatever damage has been done to our rivers. I think that you can't really attribute all this to one particular, cause or reason. It is because of, there is certain effluent coming out from factories or from the quarters of the residents, there is a lot of acid mine drainage that takes place, which results in the high acidity of these rivers. And yes, there is a certain amount of drainage that takes place from the limestone mines also. So many factors add and they compound the issue. But I think that right now what's very important for us as a forest department is to look at ways and solutions to the rejuvenation of our rivers, which are ecological in nature. So that's our effort, to make sure that whatever we do, it's not in terms of bringing in more machinery and things like that, or civil constructions. Mm-hmm. We must go back to nature and find solutions to cleaning up of our nature itself. So that's our effort, and that's where the phytoremediation program that we have right now using algae carried out through the District Mineral Fund on a pilot basis. And yesterday I went to the site where this project is being implemented, and we have seen how successfully it is being done, and that is the reason why we are looking at taking this model and replicating it everywhere else in the state, wherever the rivers are in need of rejuvenation. The funding, we are hopeful that we will be able to tap into many resources that are presently there with us. River rejuvenation is something that is permissible under many of the schemes that we have, like the Triple MRF, that's the Meghalaya Minor Minerals Reclamation Fund, and the other projects are also there, maybe CAMPA and other schemes are there. So we are examining this as to where, you know, which is the fund which will source this particular project. But we are very confident that funds will be available. The cost of one project is something that needs to be ascertained right now. I cannot really state that this project will cost this much, because it depends on the scale. This is a very scalable model. So instead of having one unit, one small unit on the bank of a river, we can always scale it up to having 4-5 units along the whole river bank. And this is also something which will also depend on the kind of community participation that we can achieve, because this project will really require active community participation. And it is for that matter that yesterday also I mentioned that community participation can only be achieved if we make the stakeholders, that is the community, active participants in this. And what I mean by active means that we must have a sustainable model whereby some form of revenue can also be generated, which will give, which will incentivize people to come forward and take participation in this. Sure of exactly how many, but we are vigorously pursuing this matter so that you know, compliance is met, and we want to ensure that as a government, as a Department of Forest and Environment, that we do not leave any stone unturned when it comes to protection of our delicate environment here. See, the preliminary, not preliminary, but the report has come out with a fact-finding exercise wherein, you know, it's not just about, you know, testing the quality of the water, the kind of toxicity level that existed in the river, the pH level of the river, but also, you know, what were the causes for this level of acidity that was there in the river. So all these have been done, and as I said, you know, that the reasons for this are many. It's not just one particular reason, and so that is an exercise which has already been carried out, and I believe that you know, the Pollution Control Board has done due diligence in ascertaining, in terms of finding out what are the causes for it. And that's why, you know, we are looking at how now we can rejuvenate and, you know, can revive our rivers now. We have already been able to identify the five or six, I'm sorry, you know, I may be mistaken here, maybe five or maybe six, of the rivers which are very critical, you know, the ones which require urgent attention. Out of which, yes, Luka is one, Umshirpi is one, Wamkra is one. So there are all these rivers which are very critical in nature. And we are therefore, you know, having our plans to take this, you know, phytoremediation method to these other rivers also. Because for us, it's very simple that, you know, the remedy to this must come from nature itself. So that's why we're going for that. But to answer your question, there are rivers which have been identified, yes. Water Resources Department has different mandates, but the mandate for river rejuvenation is with the Forest Department. The coordination is there, definitely. I'm very sure that the Forest Department is coordinating. But the as I said, we are actively engaging with the community. We are in you know, making sure that there is participation on, from their part also. And of course, you know, I'm very sure that there must be some communication going on with the district councils regarding this.